Hey guys, it's Jeremy from HowToHockey.com. In this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to shoot like Phil Kessel. Now, in a lot of his goals, he uses a very specific technique. So what I'm going to do is break down that technique for you guys, show you how it's done so you guys can practice at home. First, let's take a look at a few goals from Kessel.
So this is Kessel's typical shot. He shoots from his off foot, or his wrong foot as some coaches call it. But you can see it's 123 kilometers an hour, or 75 miles per hour, which is a lot of power for this type of shot. You just need to work on the right technique. So his technique, he's a right-handed shot. He steps and shoots off of the right foot, gets his hands away from his body, and then snaps it. So he sort of steps into it and steps onto the foot closest to the blade of the stick. If you're lefty, you're just gonna step to the left foot and shoot for the left side most of the time. So here's another one, steps to the right foot, shoots for the right side of the net. And you can see he gets his hands away from his body, good quick snap and a really quick release. You don't always have to shoot for the same side, your shooting side though. So here you can see Kessel, he's got the whole right side of the net open, but he notices the goalie is expecting the shot there, so he releases it to the left side and beats him just over the pad. So that's why I say always have your head up, read the net, and read what the goalie's doing. Some goalies that are good, they'll expect you to shoot certain places, and if you can quickly change your direction, you can score on the other side. So that's what he does here. He's right-handed shot, goes for the snapshot for the right side, but then releases it to the left side and fools the goalie.
All right, first I'm gonna quickly break down the techniques that Kessel uses in the shot. Then I'm gonna show you a few different game situations when you're gonna wanna do it. So what Kessel does here is he wants to get that puck off quickly. He sees a lane through traffic, he sees an opening in the net, and he has to get the shot off right then. So what he does is instead of trying to draw the puck back, get all this power and stuff, he just steps onto the foot closest to the puck or closest to the blade of the stick, right? And what you wanna do here is get the hands away from the body. So I'll take it to the side so you can see. You gotta get the hands out like this. What this does is it puts the stick in front of the puck. That lets you lean, get your weight over that stick and really flex it. And by flexing that stick, you're putting all kinds of potential energy in there. So you flex that stick, get the hands away from the body, the weight is over here, right? So you can lean on your stick and flex it, and then you're gonna wanna pull back this top end, push with the bottom, get a nice hard snap on net. So, different technique, all right? Another thing you want is to actually be able to flex your stick. If this is a 100 flex stick, forget about it, it's really hard to flex. I think Kessel rumored that he uses about a 70 or 75. Pro player using 70 or 75, it's a really whippy stick. So it depends on your weight. If you're really light, you need a really whippy stick. So if you're 100 pounds, you need like a 40 flex stick. If you're 200 pounds, you might get an 80 flex, right? So go in the store, see how much you can actually flex it by leaning on it. You want one that you can actually get good flex from. I'm gonna go over a couple game situations when you're gonna wanna use this type of shot. First one is when you're coming in straight on the goalie, you have a defender with you. So start by carrying the puck in front of your body. Causes the defender to line up with the puck and causes the goalie to line up with the puck. What you wanna do is quickly move the puck to your shooting side, step onto that foot, hands away from the body, and get that snap. So it looks like this. You're gonna step, hands away, get that snap on net. So why you wanna do this is because you're actually creating a better angle for your shot. You're carrying the puck in front, forcing the goalie to be in the middle of the net, line up. So you know on your shooting side there's going to be an opening there. Now you want to be quick with this. You need to quickly move the puck over and get that shot all in the same motion so you can beat the defender and the goalie at the same time. If you're in a really quick competitive game, you can even throw in a little fake. Fake to this side to cause the defender to move a little bit this way, then bring it across, get that snap. You want to get that shot off really quickly so the goalie doesn't have time to move across. Another common situation when you can use this type of shot is when you're cutting across the ice with the puck on your shooting side. There's actually two shots that you can use in this situation. I'll show you both. What's really important is to have your head up. Two reasons. You need to read the net and see where the goalie is and where you have a scoring opportunity. And you need to read the traffic in front. So if there's a bunch of guys in front, you have to always have your head up, look, look, look. When you see that opportunity, take it. All right, that's when you're going to want to use that quick snap. So what I like to do in this situation, there's two different shots. First one is if I'm cutting across, and I see the goalie moving off this post where I just came from, so the short side, I'm gonna take the actual wrist shot, right? In this situation, I'm going for the side of the net that's closest to me. So what I'm gonna do is pull the puck in here and then release it from there, and that gives me a better opportunity of scoring right here, right? Now, if I wanna go for the other side of the net, what I'm gonna do is step onto my other leg. So now, I'm gonna move the puck here, step there, and I'm releasing from right there. See the difference? So if I'm shooting for the far side, I'm moving the puck here before I release it. It gives me a better scoring opportunity. So that's the one that Phil Kessel used. That's the one I'll show you right here. So what you're doing is coming across, head up, reading the net, reading the traffic, skating. You see that opening, you step, hands away from the body, and get that snap on net. All right, so some of you guys are at home and thinking, Jeremy, you can't really shoot the puck as hard as Phil Kessel, so how are you gonna teach me to shoot like Kessel? What's really important here is the difference between technique and execution. All right, so I understand the techniques. I watch the pros, I watch their videos, I break them down in slow motion, and I see every single little thing they're doing, and then I practice it out here, and then I come and teach you guys, right? So I don't have the execution that the pros have. It's because I haven't practiced those shots 1,000 times, 10,000 times, right? That's what I want you guys to do. So I'm breaking down these techniques for you, and it's up to you to work on shot after shot after shot using the right technique. And the more times you do it, the better you're gonna get, the closer you'll get to Phil Castle. I want you guys to be able to do it better than I can, all right? So every single time you take that shot, you're gonna get a little bit more flex from that stick, a little bit of a quicker release. You're gonna get that shot off a little faster, a little bit more power every single time. So I just wanna teach you guys a good technique, and it's up to you guys to get the repetitions in so you can get that proper execution. All right, guys, that's it. Thanks a lot for watching the video. If you're looking for more shooting techniques, check out my iSnipe app. It's only $2.99. It's for Apple and Android. I have 16 different shooting videos. I teach every single shot and then 3 variations of each shot. It also has a shot tracker and a really cool training tool. So it's a really cool app if you guys can work on your shots at home. If you want to check out my other videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. And then also you can subscribe to my website. It's howtohockey.com. Thanks for watching the video. See you in the next one.